Hey guys, welcome to another December edition of Basic Brunches. It's never going to sound the same and it never will. I am your host, Stephanie. As usual, I'm doing another cider.
Hi, I'm Celeste. Because it's one of those like holiday seasons, the fun never stops. So this is a very nice mix of tequila with like a blue curacao and some extra juices. Ooh. To like cut the tequila. So it's not so much of a morning drink, but it's trying to be that. Mm. We're just going to mask it. It's fine.
Hello. I am currently boiling up some hot water and I'm going to have some hot apple cider with a bit of bourbon. So it's going to be nice. And it has cinnamon sticks inside of it. Oh. So it's going to be super festive. You know what? I'm just going to give up on the ears. Here you go, Baymax. Yay.
Hi, my name is Lucas. I am drinking again one of the Wisconsin favorite Spotted Cow, because you can't go wrong with a Spotted Cow.
We're going to be chill for a second. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about ice cream. What are some of your favorite flavors? I have a childhood memory of always eating Rocky Road ice cream every time I went to visit family members. And I just have this solid obsession with chocolate mint ice cream. Mm. You got to get that green in there. You know what I'm saying?
So I am going to plug this amazing ice cream shop. It's my favorite. In Studio City, if you live in Los Angeles, there is a place called Sonny's Ice Cream. And it is the best ice cream I've ever had. And the flavor I get there is apple pie ice cream. Okay. So it's a vanilla cinnamon based ice cream and they blend up whole pieces of apple pie into it. And then I get that and I top it with salted caramel sauce on top.
Damn, look at Erin taking notes.
Amazing. Otherwise, I also go for like dark chocolate and coffee flavors.
So ever since I was a young little child, I have always loved the staple of basic chocolate chip, like not chocolate chip cookie dough, like with vanilla. No, just plain old broken up tiny morsels of chocolate in vanilla. I just think that is the best staple, like not mint chocolate chip. No, absolutely not. Do not tarnish freaking vanilla ice cream with mint and chocolate chip. Like it's fine. I don't hate mint chocolate chip, but I prefer just the clean, minimalistic chocolate chip, vanilla base, nothing else. But I also really love this one. I think it's like peanut butter cup by Ben and Jerry's. And there's just too many flavors from Ben and Jerry's that I absolutely love. Don't skip on chocolate chip. Gelato, chocolate chip. What's that? Soft serve? Vanilla with chocolate chips. But I will always, 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 always add like toppings.
For a while, it's always been either strawberry or, you know, just regular plain vanilla. My grandma's favorite was the Neapolitan ice cream. It would be that sort of meme that people would like flock to the strawberry and the vanilla, but leave chocolate alone. Yeah, that's how it was. I would eat vanilla and then strawberry and then chocolate. I'm just like, maybe I'll have you in like a couple weeks. That was before the lactose intolerant trait kicked in. So I've been trying to focus more on like gelatos and water-based cold items. There's actually a really cool place in Hawai'i and they serve shaved ice. There's a place in Koreatown that sells really good shaved ice. The first place I was talking about, the Hawaiian shaved place, got Matsumoto shaved ice. And then for the one in Koreatown, Sul Bean.
So definitely check some of these places out. They're obviously going to be delicious. Okay. Moving on, we're going to talk about some things about winter and the holidays that we love. And we want to know what things in the winter and during the holidays that you love. I for sure am obsessed with snow. Only because I've lived in Los Angeles since I was 8 and we just don't get snow, period, ever here. It's garbage. But fresh fallen snow upon the earth in a winter wonderland of the forest with the smell of evergreen and pine. It's just a magical, magical smell. I'm a weirdo. I also like hot chocolate and peppermint.
Christmas being my favorite holiday, it's the reason of being just together with your family and friends. Besides Thanksgiving, that's when I can see my entire extended out family. And with us, of course, we have thousands of cousins. So I gotta visit all my cousins and then I gotta visit on my stepdad's side. It's just very nice to see everyone after a while, you know, definitely catch up because for so long, you still connect with those family members. It's like you never left them. I take over all of the decorations. So putting up decoration and just kind of redoing the entire house is so magical for me. It's just like, it gives me that sense of, okay, it's the holidays. We are calm. I have my candle on. I have hot chocolate. Everybody is going to enjoy the holidays.
I also agree with both of you two. I love hot chocolate. I love hot chocolate under a nice cozy blanket. Like having a nice fuzzy blanket and having a nice hot chocolate and just cozying up and being like all bundly watching Christmas movies. It's like such a good feeling. And like Christmas movies always have like this like wonderful like moral and it's like, oh, da 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 da. Except for Christmas Story with a lamp leg. So it's like, don't get it. Like a lady leg lamp for Christmas. You don't get that. Like, don't get it as a present for yourself because that's going to suggest something. But I really like decorating like the Christmas tree. I think it's so much fun. Except I do not like really quickly having to make 12 giant head-sized multi-layered ribbons. My trees do not have ribbons for a reason because I don't want to make them anymore. But they look good. I love ornament shopping. I think ornament shopping and just seeing what people create is so much fun. It's like every year we try to get like one brand new ornament per us. So we have one that's like a hamburger and one's like a bulldog. And we try to commemorate what we've done in the year with our ornaments. So every time we put up the Christmas tree, we're like, oh, this is what we did in this year. Oh, this is what we did in that year. Oh, what good memories. And we just like step back and see it. And it's like, ah, that was crazy. And then we're just like sipping our drinks. So I really like that.
Growing up in Wisconsin, when it comes to snow, I'm just like, I don't want anything to do with it. You have to shovel it and you have to salt your walkways so you don't fall on your... It's really nice to look at. And it's really nice to experience for like a week. But here, our winters last like almost 5 months. So it's like, nah. But I do enjoy being inside. And like Celeste said, snuggling up with a blanket, a nice hot cup of hot cocoa. And then my favorite things too is also decorating a lot of lights. I like putting string lights up everywhere that glow of the lights. You don't have any house lights on. It's just the glow of the lights in your house from your string
lights.
Erin. It's like, right. Like Erin's. Yes. And then also cooking. I think food and like warm, really heavy, just like comfort foods in the winter that you share with the people you love. That is really what that time is about. It's using, you know, the stuff you've harvested in the fall to get you through the winter, and you just hunker down, you stick together, and you know, it's just a good time. Also lots of alcohol, because that'll get you through the winter as well.
That's how you stay warm.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Let's get into game time.
Game time.
We're gonna do another game of Never Have I Ever. And of course we're gonna be drinking, because what's a game without drinking? First one, Never Have I Ever traveled overseas.
Actually, no.
I like how Erin's thinking, but I'm like, you have to drink. You went over the Pacific Ocean to Hawaii.
Never have I ever eaten a chocolate frog, and not just any chocolate frog, a Harry Potter themed chocolate frog.
Definitely drink to that.
Oh, you got your drink? Get your drink.
Wait, Steph, you didn't drink? Cheater!
Never have I ever staked out for a convention ticket. If you tried going to San Diego Comic-Con, you gotta drink to this. It's just mandatory, which I have.
Just never... you, Steph.
So the thing about that, San Diego Comic-Con falls on my birthday weekend usually, so my whole goal when I lived in LA was to become like famous enough to get there for free. So that's why I would never wait.
Never have I ever walked on a 50-foot pole blindfolded. This guy.
Like, I'm sorry, but that's pure fall and die culture right there. Like, you're gonna walk on a 50-foot pole? Excuse me?
Let me give some backstory. I also jumped off the pole. But I was harnessed.
Why would anyone else do that?
I was harnessed in to a...
Oh my gosh.
So you had to climb up this 50-foot pole blindfolded, get on top of the pole, and there is a rubber chicken hanging like 10 feet from the pole, and you had to jump off blindfolded and grab the chicken. It was for my outdoor adventure class in high school.
I thought this was going to be for like a reality TV show, but
it
all
could
right.
have been. That'd be a better story.
Yes, I have to applaud your exotic life.
Never have I ever crawled 20 feet through a 2x1 cave.
I got 6 feet in and then I couldn't do it.
Why were you doing this? Like you said, you would explain these.
For the outdoor adventure class, so we went spelunking in a cave system, and to get out the end of the cave, it was a 2 by 1 foot hole that you had to crawl through on your back through the mud to get out to the end of the cave. And I got 6 feet in, and the stone is like right here by your face. And I was like, no, this isn't happening. So I like went back out.
As an older, mature Asian woman, I'd be like, you're crazy.
Never have I ever had a legendary Christmas dinner at a Chinese restaurant, just like in Christmas Story, and the server chopped the head in front of us.
Oh my god, Erin.
Backstory on that. No matter what, my family would always include Chinese food in whatever holiday we're celebrating. But this time we decided to go out to Chinatown. They bring out the entire chicken and the entire duck, which includes the heads as well. And my grandma, she loved the heads. It would already be cut off, or they would cut it off in front of us. And I'm just kind of like, cool.
Some exotic stories being exchanged today. That's fabulous.
That concludes the end of game time. Traditionally, this is now the time for shout outs.
Of course, I've been a regular on the channel. You can check out my links down in the description. I do YouTube, Twitch, and I have my Instagram and Facebook as well. Go ahead and check me out. And of course, thank you so much to Nontalk for having me on again. So, yay!
Of course, my name is Lucas. I have an Instagram, My Sarcastic Kitchen. If you want any inspiration on some winter foods to make, I'll be making lots of things this winter. If you want to check them out, go there and just DM me for some recipes.
And my name is Erin. I have a Instagram that goes by Erith Doe, and I also have a Twitch called Erith Streams. I play a lot of Switch games and have a regular schedule, and I'm just excited to have more games to stream until I get a PC. Woo-hoo. But yeah, that's all I have.
Don't forget to check out all the other shows that are here on Nontalk Network. Definitely the live streams that are on Facebook. And we are going to transfer over to Twitch starting in January, just because that's just the place to be. We need to get with the times. But also, other than that, thank you, Erin, Lucas, and Celeste for being on the show again. Everybody just be safe, celebrating whatever you're celebrating. I'm Stephanie, and this has been Basic Brunches. Bye.